Hello students, in the continuation of lesson 3, first phase of the Indian nationalist movement, today we will know about the prominent moderate leaders. The first one is Dada Bhai Nauroji, popularly known as the Grand Old Man of India. He was born on 4th September 1825 in a Parsi family. He was Parsi intellectual, educator, cotton trader and an early Indian political leader. Dada Bhai sailed for England in 1855. During his long stay in England, he was looked upon as India's unofficial ambassador fighting for the cause of his country. He was one of the founder members of Indian National Congress. In 1865, he founded the London Indian Society with the help of W.C. Banerjee. He also founded Bombay Association. In 1866, he founded East India Association in London. His book, Poverty and Un-British Rule in India, brought into limelight the drain of India's wealth into Britain. He also started a magazine, Dharma Marg Darshak, and edited the newspaper Ross Gofter, The Truth Teller. It was an Anglo-Gujarati paper started in 1854. He was a member of parliament in the British House of Commons between 1892 and 1895. This was indeed a historic occasion as Dada Bhai became the first Indian or Asian member of the British parliament. He became the Congress President thrice, in 1886 AD, in 1893 AD, in 1906 AD. His role in Congress. He was a moving spirit and original founders of Congress. He laid the foundation of early nationalist politics and principles of constitutional agitation. Under his presidentship, a resolution passed on Swadeshi, Swaraj, boycott and national education. He also laid stress on the important rights of the Indian people, that is, increasing employment in public service, increasing representation in legislative council, right to just and friendly relations between India and England. Dada Bhai presented to put British people the drain theory, which put before them the facts and figures illustrating systematic bleeding of wealth and resources of India through salaries payable to the members of the Indian Council, dispatch of savings to England by British officers posted in India, pensions to the British officers, payment to the War Office for the maintenance of British troops in India, and profits of the British trading agencies. His ideas were put into a volume called Poverty and Un-British Rule in India. This was a change against the British Empire. Then he asked for immediate appointment of a royal commission to look into charges. Dada Bhai Nauroji was one of the members of the royal commission that was known as the Walpai Commission. He passed away in 1917. Next is Gopal Krishna Gokhale. He was born in 1866. He was a professor of history and economics at Ferguson College in Pune. He was greatly influenced by the ideals of Justice M.G. Ranade and joined his Deccan Education Society. He was awarded the title CIE, means Companion of the Indian Empire. In his autobiography, Gandhiji calls Gokhale his mentor and guide. That's why he is best known as the political guru of Gandhiji. Gokhale became a member of Congress in 1889 AD. Gokhale supported the Indianization of civil services, reduction in salt duty and spread of education in advanced technology, administration and health. Gokhale became the Congress President in 1905 AD. He opposed the partition of Bengal. He played an important role in bringing the Minto Mohanlal reforms of 1980, he also strongly stressed the need of separation of executive from the judiciary and criticized the huge expenditure on the British Army. As a member of the Central Legislative Assembly, he moved a resolution for reduction in excise duty, relief to the bonded labor in South Africa, revival of the village panchayat and other local bodies. The Servants of Indian Society was formed in Pune, Maharashtra in 1905 by Gopal Krishna Gokhale. He left the Deccan Education Society to form this association. Along with him, there were a small group of educated Indians. The society organized many campaigns to promote education, especially women education, sanitation, health care and fight and social evils of untouchability and discrimination, poverty, etc. In 1902, Gokhale had become the member of the Imperial Legislative Council. He pleaded in the council for reduction in salt duty and the abolition of excise duty on cotton goods. Gokhale was a champion of compulsory education and tried to introduce a bill with a view to making primary education compulsory. He had a great knowledge about the country's economy. Being an economist, he demanded radical changes, better jobs for the educated middle class. Gokhale and Gandhiji. In 1912, Gokhale went to South Africa, where he helped Gandhiji in his fight against racial discrimination. Gandhiji accepted Gokhale as his political mentor. Gokhale died on February 15, 1950. Next is Surendranath Banerjee. He was born in Calcutta in a Brahmin Hindu family. He was deeply influenced by the liberal progressive thinking by his father, Durga Charan Banerjee, a doctor. Banerjee was educated at the Parental Academic Institution and at the Hindu College. After graduating from the University of Calcutta, he travelled to England to sit for the Indian Civil Services examinations. He cleared the ICS examination and was posted as Assistant Magistrate in Sylhet. Banerjee was dismissed soon from his job because of the racial discrimination. Banerjee went to England to protest this decision but was unsuccessful. Surendranath Banerjee was elected to the Bengal Legislative Council for several times. In 1921, he was appointed as the Minister of Self-Government and Health by the Governor of Bengal. He was the first Indian to hold this post. Indian Association. Surendranath founded the Indian Association. He used the organization to tackle the issue of age limit for Indian students appearing for ICS exams, which was reduced from 21 to 19. The Indian Association maintained its objective to make the people of India united in the political field. The Indian Association wanted to create the feelings of awakening and consciousness among the people of India. Surendranath Banerjee visited different parts of India and made efforts to awaken the people of India. The Indian Association also started a movement against the Arms Act and the Vernacular Press Act. It also opposed Mohanlal Minto Reforms 1909, License Act and the Partition of Bengal. This organization also demanded to bring changes in the rent bill in order to protect the rights of the tenants. The Indian Association also started a movement to improve and develop the condition of those laborers who were working in the tea gardens of the British. Surendranath Banerjee took a leading part in the formation of the Indian National Congress. He called a meeting of the Indian National Congress in 1883 AD, which was the first meeting of leaders from all over India. Surendranath Banerjee was elected at the Congress President twice, that is in 1895 AD and 1902 AD. He was called the Indian Gladstone for his oratory and Indian Edmund Burke for his combining oratory and knowledge. Surendranath believed in the constitutional agitation and supported representative institutions. He stressed the need for Hindu-Muslim unity. Surendranath Banerjee actively opposed the partition of Bengal brought about by Lord Curzon. He supported the Swadeshi movement and the boycott of the foreign goods. He also believed in Swaraj, that is India's right to self-government, supporting the Swadeshi. Surendranath edited a newspaper called Bengali. His book, A Nation in Making, gives an account of his political concern and his views about self-government. He died on 6 August 1925. Now the lesson is over here. You have to learn all the important dates, all the important terms, and do the question answers.